Hi, I'm Rhys Darby. You might have seen me kicking around New York with those other Kiwi exports, the Flight of the Conchords. But hopefully I'm about to co-star with some more interesting creatures. The mountain gorillas of Rwanda.
Malaria tablets. Vaccination side effects. I've travelled a lot with my job as a stand-up all through the world, but I haven't been to anywhere developing. Bigfoot. Oh, I've never had to rough it. I'm quite apprehensive because you hear the stories, but at the same time, I'm very excited. It's about stepping outside your comfort zone, and I've done that since the year dot, so I think I'm just going to go in blind. It's the best way. Do an intrepid journey because I've been privileged over the last few years and I wanted to do something that would be challenging and eye-opening. Throwing caution to the wind, and so far it's been good. I've only been here a couple of hours though. Hey!
The landlocked Republic of Rwanda is in Central Africa. I'll start in the capital, Kigali, then stay in a cultural village for 3 days on the edge of the Volcanoes National Park, home to the mountain gorillas. I'll test my fear of bats on Lake Kivu and travel to the Congo border town of Kamembe. I'll end my journey at the Akagara National Park, where I hope to fulfill a lifelong dream of seeing an elephant in the wild.
To Rwanda, so I'm going to go down to see if I can get some socks, some gloves, and a cool hat. I want socks. You have any socks? Oh yes, they're good. I like those. I'll get all these.
Okay,
5,000. There you go. I need some gloves because I'm going to go through the forest, and there could be stinging nettle. I'll give you 200. All right, forget it. All right, 300. 2,000. Okay, well, that went well. I'm not a great haggler. I haven't been given plastic bags, you'll notice, to put these in, and that's because plastic bags are banned in Rwanda. They're illegal, you can't use them. You'll also find that Rwanda is a very clean place, and it's because once a month they have a national clean-up day, and everyone in the country stops work and cleans for the whole day. And they love the pride that they get from having such a clean, beautiful country. It's a great thing. Right, so I need some hats. For that.
Currency is the Rwandan franc. I'll get 320 of these to my Kiwi dollar. It's not a cheap country, $15 for a G&T. And a visit to the mountain gorillas will set me back over 8 hundi.
It's been an amazing experience in the markets. Felt like I was in the All Whites and we'd just won the World Cup or something and I was the captain. I think I need a little bit of alone time now. Dear Mum, Rwanda is just what you said it would be. Vibrant, full of colour, and exciting. The food is fantastic. How's Dad? Miss you lots. Love, Reese. Right. I'm walking on the high street of Kigali. It's very busy. It's customary to walk on the road. Reminds me a bit of New York, actually, with all the tooting. Hey! It's going through a very powerful, happy, exciting time.
Oh, fantastic.
Rebuilding. Everyone's very positive now to start again after the history that's had recently.
And the recent history of Rwanda has been grim. In 1994, 1 million Rwandans were victims of a genocide, while the world watched in horror but did nothing. Thousands were killed inside this church, where their clothes remain.
My first impressions
were that I was just staring at a whole bunch of old clothes. It's not till you look at each piece of clothing individually that you get the impression each one represents a life and everyone's different. Each piece of clothing is different and each life had hopes and dreams. They're all shattered in terror. And when I saw the hat, that struck me the most because it's the sort of thing I would wear. I like hats.
What's even more bizarre is the complete faith and trust in each other now that they all have. These people are willing and are completely able to forgive and build something better from that terrible base. These people are very, very strong, and they all have complete faith that it will never happen again.
And the silence, very, very quiet in there as well. And I didn't want to stay in there too long.
Yeah, I'm new to this kind of thing because I've been brought up so sheltered and the youngest of five kids by 9 years, spoilt, babied by my older sisters. Even though I've done a lot of things that have been challenging, where there's risks and things, life has been easy for me.
I'm leaving the capital and heading to the Volcanoes National Park. For the next 3 nights, I'll be living in a cultural village in Ruhengari. 3 years ago, most of the people here survived by poaching wildlife. But this community project was set up to change all that so the local people could earn money from tourism.
I'm going to be king.
This is King's Conference Room.
Conference room. So it's like a meeting house.
Yeah, meeting.
Yes. So that's the bed, the big bed.
Yeah. What sort of springs?
Oh, okay.
You should sleep with like three wives. You should call one of them, come and sleep. And after making sex, he calls other one, come and sleep. Each the place, other like that.
And then the other two wives just wait their turn.
Yeah, yeah.
Read a book or what have you, and then they can hear.
Yeah.
When it's their turn. Next. That sort of thing, is it? Yeah. That's great.
Yes.
Utilized for meetings, and the waiting, and then the mass fornication.
Yes.
This is banana beer.
Woo, the king's drink.
It makes my...
Oh, really?
Makes
so the more banana beer he drinks, the better decisions are made.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the taste, well, it's pretty much bananas meat tequila. It's quite strong.
The kids here are learning to be proud of their culture. All the money earned from the tourism goes back into community projects. Preserving the wildlife here is now generating prosperity for the entire village, not just the few people who poached for bush meat and the exotic pet trade. Their enthusiasm is infectious, so I can't say no to a chance of beating the jungle drums.
My arms are really, really sore. But you get into the rhythm and it just feels like you're part of one big beat. And it's a lot of energy, a lot of fun.
Just to let you know, I'm drinking 10% banana beer and these blokes drink 2 litres of this at 20% alcohol. And I've been on this 1 litre for the last 3 hours.
The two elders are sort of competing to express how important they are in the community and the history of the things that they've done. It's a bit like a one-on-one sort of Eminem situation, lose yourself, a bit like a rap-off.
The elders are basically telling the rest of them how great they are. Some of it's tall stories, you know, oh yes, you know, I've got the most cows and I've been with the most girls, and you know, the others are laughing and you know, that's probably not even true, but it's just a lot of fun.